हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट ब्रोंकियल अस्थमा. ब्रोंकियल अस्थमा, हियर यू विल सी दैट देयर इज रिवर्सिबल ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एयरवे ड्यू टू हाइपर रेस्पॉन्सिवनेस ऑफ वेरियस स्टिम्यूलाई. इट कैन हैव सम ट्रिगर्स लाइक इट. ब्रोंकियल अस्थमा कैन बी ड्यू टू इन्फेक्शन और डस्ट और एलर्जी, or it can be due to cold air or exercise or stress. All these can lead to bronchial asthma. A bronchial asthma patient presents with recurrent coughs and wheezing episode with respiratory distress, and these episodes are more common or worse at night, and there is presence of family history being positive. Then the patient also have the diagnosis is mainly done by the clinical history along with the investigations, where if you do absolute eosinophil count, this absolute eosinophil count is found to be elevated, and there is IgE level will also be found to be elevated. Pulmonary function test, here FEV1 is found to be decreased, but FVC ratio will be elevated. So FEV1 by FVC ratio is approximately less than 0.8. And if you do peak expiratory flow rate, this peak expiratory flow rate shows a diurnal. It shows a diurnal variation. Sorry, it shows a diurnal variation of more than 20% of peak expiratory flow rate. Then if you do, this might even cause improvement of almost more than 20% can be seen after giving a bronchodilator. Improvement of peak expiratory flow rate can be seen in more than 20% after you give a bronchodilator, because bronchodilator will dilate the constricted airways. Treatment is first and first. If there are any triggers, all these triggers should be eliminated. Then you can give education to the patients. Then pharmacotherapy can be started with bronchodilators, where you can give salbutamol, which is short acting bronchial agonists, sorry, beta agonists, or you can even give ipratropium bromide, which is an anticholinergic. Both these will cause bronchodilation. You can also give steroids to the patient. Mostly inhalational are preferred, unless it is status epilepticus. We do not prefer, or severe asthma, we do not prefer IV steroids. Then you can also give mast cell inhibitors, sorry, mast cell stabilizers, which will obviously inhibit the mast cells. Like sodium chromoglycate can be used. Okay, next, if you see, you can have leukotriene modifiers. Leukotriene modifiers include two types. We have Montelukast and we have Zafirlukast. These Montelukast or Zafirlukast are mainly used for exercise induced asthma or seasonal asthma, and we can even give theophylline to the patient. Right, even IgE, anti-IgE antibodies, which include omalizumab, can also be given in modified and to severe cases of allergic asthma in children more than 12 years of age. If you see, the first line treatment of asthma is we can do inhalational therapy in first line treatment of asthma, and we can use pressured meter dose inhaler can be given along with plus or minus spacer can be added, or you can use face mask also if a child is less than 4 years. If a child is less than 4 years, then we use this face mask, or else we can just give pressurized meter dose inhaler with pacer can be given. With older children, only with the help of pressurized meter dose inhaler we can give the drug. So how do you quantify. We have a stepwise treatment for this bronchial asthma. So first step is, if the this is based on two things: daytime frequency of asthma and nighttime frequency of the asthma. Okay, if there is less, the daytime frequency of asthma is less than 1 per week, and if the nighttime frequency is less than 2 per month, then it is called as first step, where you give only short acting bronchial agonists as and when needed. Then in step 2, if there is daytime frequencies are more than once per week, but they are less than once per day. Okay, if the daytime frequencies are more than once per week but they are less than once per day, then nighttime frequency is more than 10 per month, then we can give short acting bronchial agonists with low dose inhalational corticosteroids or leukotriene modifiers can be given. Then step 3, here if there is more than once episode per day, or that is in the daytime, and at night if there is more than one episode per month, then we can use short acting bronchial agonists plus medium dosed inhalational corticosteroids with long acting bronchial agonists can be given. Then in stage 4, here if there is continuous limitation of physical activity is seen in the days and even night time also, if the episodes are frequent, in such cases we give short acting bronchial agonists with high dose of inhaled corticosteroids plus long acting bronchial agonists plus or minus oral steroids. So this is for the treatment of bronchial asthma. Thank you for watching.